Tristan Thompson to the Los Angeles Lakers. Now, wait. Before you punch and or throw your screen, hear me out. I think I can explain why that might not be the worst thing ever. I'm Trevor Lane for LakersNation.com, your home for the 2020 NBA champion, 17 times, Los Angeles Lakers. Do me a favor. Make sure you do. Subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel and ring that notification bell right over there so you get notified every time we go live, which we're actually doing tonight, Monday, November 2nd. We're going to go live at 8 o'clock Pacific time tonight. We're going to move it up an hour and we're going to talk Lakers basketball directly with you. Okay, so Tristan Thompson and the Lakers, LeBron James, look, it feels like there's some connections there, and things heated up again when LeBron and Tristan Thompson hung out. It looked like they were together for the Clutch Sports Pro Day, which brought some attention to Tyrese Maxey, Anthony Edwards, some of the Clutch Sports rookies. And in fact, there was a little bit of drama around that. Some other agents, some non-Clutch Sports agents, weren't thrilled with how much attention was being given to those Clutch Sports clients, but you know, that's agent drama. Rich Paul fired back after an anonymous report made its way out there. And Rich Paul fired back. LeBron fired back too. But again, that's agent drama. LeBron also took to Twitter to mention how much fun he had meeting up with Tristan Thompson, of course, his old teammate with the Cleveland Cavaliers. And here's where it gets interesting. He also included, he finished it with, "More to come, bro, for sure." Now, is that foreshadowing to maybe Tristan Thompson coming to the Lakers? Well, look, LeBron is very calculated. He understands that everything he says, everything he puts out on social media is going to be analyzed and dissected. And so, I mean, look, this isn't going to squash the rumors about a Tristan Thompson-LeBron James reunion in Los Angeles. And look, it wouldn't be the worst thing ever. See, here's what happens. This is what I think has happened with Tristan Thompson. And Kardashian curse aside, I know a lot of people are worried about that. And I get it. I get it. That's scary stuff. But Tristan Thompson is one of those players where their contract kind of bleeds into their perception as a player. Sometimes when a player's contract is higher than what we think they're worth, it influences how we see their play on the floor. For example, when we talk about Chris Paul, how many people talk about how terrible his contract is? Sure, but if Chris Paul was making $5 million instead of $40 million, everybody would want him. He is still a very valuable player on the floor. And I think we can apply the same thing to Tristan Thompson. Is he worth the $18.5 million he made last season from the Cavs? No. The Clutch Sports did a great job getting him that contract, and he made more than market value. He's not worth that, but is he worthless? No, of course not. He's actually a really good player. In fact, he can help out the Lakers in a few ways. So let's pretend that we're living in a world where the Lakers need another big, and so that means that either JaVale McGee opted out of his player option. Unlikely. But let's say maybe he picked it up and the Lakers used him in a trade. That's possible. Also possible, Dwight Howard gets a big offer somewhere else and the Lakers decide they don't want to match it. Let's say some team offers him $10 million a year. Maybe it's the Warriors. Somebody offers him a lot of money and the Lakers say, no, we're going to go find a replacement out on the market. I'd be sad. I like what we've seen out of Dwight Howard this season, but they would need to find a replacement. And I think you could do worse than Tristan Thompson. Here's the thing. We tend to look for bigs in the modern NBA who can do two things, who can shoot threes and block a lot of shots, protecting the rim. If you can do those two things, you're going to be pretty good at the center position, especially in the modern NBA. Tristan Thompson doesn't do either of those things, and so we look at that negatively instead of focusing on the things that he does well. He actually can shoot a little bit from three, but he doesn't shoot very many of them, and his rim protection is just okay. He didn't quite block one shot per game last season, and that was with him getting about 30 minutes. What he excels at, though, is defending on the perimeter. He is a versatile defender that can check players out on the perimeter better than most modern bigs can. And that has caused him to be a plus defender just about everywhere on the floor. In fact, the only place that players shoot better than their average against Tristan Thompson is from behind the three-point line. Everywhere else, from the mid-range all the way to the rim, he negatively impacts field goal percentage. And that's a good thing. That's something that you want to have. He is also phenomenal as a rebounder. He is a monster on the boards. In fact, he was second in the NBA last season in offensive rebounds. Now, Okay, so we do have to note that he played for the Cavaliers. The Cavaliers were not a good team. They missed a lot of shots. That creates more opportunity for offensive rebounds. But still, he is a strong rebounder. So imagine this scenario. Let's say you're a team and you're trying to defend the Lakers. And you're defending LeBron and you're defending Anthony Davis. And you're worried about the shooters they have around them. And you're flying all over the court. And you get a stop. The Lakers shoot and they miss. And then, oh, Tristan Thompson gets the offensive board and either puts it back up and in or he kicks it back out. And now you have to defend the Lakers all over again. You were already talking about the reigning defending champions. And now you have a guy where every time you actually get them to miss a shot, he's gobbling that up and he is getting the Lakers extra scoring opportunities. Can you imagine how demoralizing, how defeating that would be for a team to have to deal with? Again, I'm not saying Tristan Thompson is a world beater. Personally, I think they should also take a look at, say, a DeMarcus Cousins. I know there's going to be a number of bigs out there on the market. Serge Ibaka, Marc Gasol, the list goes on and on and on. There's a lot of bigs that are going to be available on the market, but it does feel like with the history and with LeBron's recent tweet and the fact that Tristan Thompson is a clutch sports guy, it feels like if the Lakers do wind up needing a big, Tristan Thompson's probably going to get the call. And again, I don't think that would be the worst thing ever. He's not the shot blocker that Dwight is or JaVale McGee is. But I think the other things that he can do in terms of defensive versatility could really help. In fact, how did the Lakers win an NBA championship this year? Was it by playing a true center? No. When it was crunch time, the Lakers went smaller. They went with guys who could defend out on the perimeter. That's where we saw more Markieff Morris. That's where we saw even the Lakers go completely small in Game 6 against the Miami Heat, where Anthony Davis was the 5 and LeBron technically was the 4 on defense. So having that kind of defensive versatility is something that Frank Vogel is going to really value. And so because of all those things, I think Tristan Thompson actually could be a pretty decent fit with your Los Angeles Lakers. All right, guys, let me know what you think. How much would you be willing to spend to get Tristan Thompson into town if the Lakers do wind up needing a big? Let me know in the comments down below. And don't forget, follow Lakers Nation across social media at Lakers Nation on Twitter and Facebook, at Lakers Nation Official on Instagram. And if you want to follow me, you can find me at Trevor_Lane on Twitter, at Trevor Lane NBA on Instagram. Till next time, stay safe and see ya.